a heart attack.
You're asking me?
Yeah. I like it all.
You like it all?
Whatever you want. It's fine with me. Anything Christ over 47 seconds. I'm not too cool in case you came on 47 seconds.
Well, it shouldn't be anything up to them. Listen to me, take my time. Including fear, you whisper, maybe?
Which one?
You whisper, which is that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Track 5. Which also means that it's a song I'm playing tonight. You whisper, that's a good one, isn't it?
Do you want to play it?
No, she's going to play it on the CD.
That's great.
What do we do? Queen Latifah, Elvis Costello.
You can do that, you gotta accompany yourself
on here. Yeah, right.
You can do that, you can open the mic.
Let's out the royal brain.
Now, yeah, this song's on the table.
Okay. I'm gonna have to get in here too, if that's okay.
Okay. Where do you want me to be then?
That's cool. Right there.
The trapped curving tongue.
Oh, I have queued
the
up.
The cage of mouth springs open.
Okay, how come they don't touch the gun is what I have queued up here.
Okay.
You wanna play first or you wanna wait until we've got something going?
Let's get something going. Because then it sort of relaxes the atmosphere, doesn't it?
Definitely.
I don't know where she is. Do you want to do it?
It's
just
a flat point.
I don't know how to use it.
Oh, really?
Track 3. Question with answers.
Here you go.
Is that okay with you?
Sure.
We'll just talk about this one and do that.
I like the fact you're playing one track for every album.
We want to do a variety.
So explain to me, how to do it, or I'll screw up.
That's okay with you.
Keep it what?
Keep it on one. Just your new stuff. We want to do everything.
I don't understand.
Never mind. Out. Steps away. Get him in.
Do you need to know what I sound like before we do it?
Whatever. What? Get a minute.
Needles and stuff, I mean, is there?
No, everything's fine.
All right, so I'm just going to say.
As we do it.
Dripping through window pane.
What we're going to do is talk about this stuff.
Yep.
And I'm going to go to questions without answers, and then we'll do something live after we do that.
Okay.
The reel's rolling in there.
You hit.
Mike, sure.
Want to say hello?
Hello.
There you go.
Hello.
30 seconds. I might have to lean down a little bit because it's not going to be a
I pity you because you are just a machine.
Okay, good.
It's almost done.
Kate Bush, my hero.
Yeah. She's wonderful, isn't she?
Yeah.
If there's anything that you want to play from anybody else around here,
oh, yeah?
Please.
Oh, God.
Here we go.
Hit it.
Are you telling me or are you asking me? Album 88, playing Marty Wilson Piper from Art Attack, Elvis Costello, Queen Latifah, and the Go-Betweens. And speaking of Marty Wilson Piper, he's live with us here in the studio. Welcome to Atlanta.
Thank you very much. Nice to be here.
Come on up to the microphone
if you can. I'd like to get closer to you. Well, I must be in bed if we get any closer.
You'll be playing tonight. Where are you going to play with us?
The Point.
Okay.
Not that I know what that is or where it is.
Yeah, it's a nice club in Atlanta, The Point.
Yeah.
Tonight, with anybody else? Are you playing by yourself?
I think it's a couple of people opening up, although I'm not really sure who they are.
Okay. You want to talk about some things. You're living in Sweden right now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The events in Eastern Europe, I'm sure, have affected you a lot.
Yeah, they
How about your writing?
Yeah, well, it's funny because I mean, although I'm not here kind of on a church level tour, you know, there's a track on the new Church record called Russian Autumn Heart, mm-hmm. which I think is probably directly affected by that, living in Sweden. I mean, the next nearest country to me is Russia. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just across the Baltic Sea, so This whole thing of having, picking up the newspaper around Christmas and seeing Ceausescu assassinated, executed on the, executed on the front page of the newspaper, it's an incredible thing.
What about Germany?
Yeah, well, you know, the reunification of Germany, fueling the fears of certain European nations, such as Poland, who wonder if Karl's ambiguity about the German territory, which belonged to Germany before the war, now belongs to Poland, and whether he's going to demand it back, things such as that. I think that's a very serious and difficult problem. I don't know how it's going to end up. Although I think Germany should outwardly say that, well, yeah, we lost that. And as Poland have said in the newspapers recently, they're saying that the only way that the Polish border is going to change with Germany is if there is a war, and Germany knows that.
Has it affected your writing? Have you written anything to
Well, I haven't. It only happened about 5 minutes ago, you know, and I've sort of been on the road with my old songs.
And you've had your latest out.
Yeah, my latest album sort of came out, was recorded in January of 1989, although it was released in October. And so I sort of haven't got to it yet, but I mean, all this stuff has always been very interesting to me. That's one of the reasons I like to live in Europe. One of my greatest ambitions was to travel around and live in Eastern Europe. Now I'm really going to be able to do it. You know?
And you're right there while all that's
right
happening.
There. I mean, from Stockholm where I live to Leningrad, it's just like, you know.
You think it'll change
$60
any
or something?
You know? You think it'll change your music the next time something comes out?
Well, I don't know. I mean, things like that do affect me because as I said earlier, it's something that interests me. I don't know. I suppose I might. I don't want to write an obvious cliched song called, you know, Communism is Dead or anything.
Well, questions without answers. You just made a video to it.
Yeah, in Stockholm. It was
the first
location.
Single off of Rhyme.
Yeah.
Okay. Want to listen to it? You want to tell us anything about it before we play?
Yeah. Well, it's funny. That song was. I actually wrote that song in Los Angeles, which is peculiar because I think that's kind of the most American song I've ever written. And it's I kind of dedicate that song to Amnesty International, who I think is an amazing organization.
Okay, so we're listening to it. Questions without answers from the brand new in Rhyme from Marty Wilson Piper on Your New Music FM, album 88.
Ooh, did you not get into it? Sit here. Is it
true? That was fun.
Does it sound okay, or do we need to up the levels or whatever? Okay.
Notes.
I always make notes. I'm a very prepared person. Okay. Do you want to do Evil Queen of England or not?
Do you want to, yeah. I mean, Evil Queen of England is a very topical and typical. I mean, if we're going to get political today, then Evil Queen of England is right there, you know.
Okay.
I can love you, though. I know you're just a machine, but I can love you like a real flesh and blood creature. But you can't love me back.
You know he's going to air this over the television station. We have students that are going to watch this.
Good.
Okay, good.
They'll enjoy that. Cool.
Okay.
What's that?
So, okay, what do you want to play? Live.
I'm going to play Melody of the Way.
Okay. We're going to do it right after this. You do it. Are levels okay? I'm talking about it. Let's do this.
As soon as it
was
on fire,
I was going to. How's it going up there? Our levels are best. You know? Is everything going? Wonderful.
Where is the glamour?
There is no glamour in radio. It's all a myth. That's right. We're all faceless people. Jim knows about it.
You should see the horror.
Now I see your face.
Yeah. Cascade is there because Cascade is only on rhyme because I have the ability to write tracks like that. I don't really know if I really like to write tracks like that. You know what I mean? I can do it, but I don't know if I enjoy doing it. Yeah. You know, I mean, I respect it from the point of view that it's pop. And classic pop is what it's all about, in a way. Or you don't? Well, of course, the thing with Cascade is that it's musically very obvious and lyrically unobvious, which is another reason why it's on there. Because the words are a bit weird. And also, I wrote that song 8 years ago.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah.
Okay, it's pretty wild.
Yeah.
I'm gonna talk about influences. Is that okay with you? You wanna play any tracks of influences, or do you not
want
to talk about that?
Yeah, I mean, how long have we got? I'll stay
we
all day and play
as much as you want.
Sacrifice the servants to the kings.
You can stay and play all day if you want.
Yeah?
Alex says, yeah, that's fine with me. Do you want to play any of your influences? I don't know if we have anything on the wall that you'd like, but...
Yeah, you could maybe play that Patti Smith album.
Which one?
The one that I just saw there, Horses. Break It Up. Yeah, I just saw it there. No, Horses. Because our new drummer in the church. Yeah, that one. This is our new drummer.
Oh, really? Okay, yeah. Do you want to talk about that or not?
Yeah, I don't mind.
Okay. I didn't know whether or not you wanted to talk about the church while you're here.
Yeah, why don't I talk about that? There's no point going too far into it.
Do you want to play anything?
Yeah.
What?
Break It Up. Okay. Smith and Verlaine right there. Break it. Delaney's fantastic guitar playing. I'm getting into this, Kevin. Oh, you are, yeah.
Am I supposed to be thrilled or what?
Yeah.
Who's this?
Barry Crack.
Is this Sod?
Oh, God. We got the cameraman from the signal, probably.
Are you videoing this?
Yeah.
I'll be damned.
Man, we pull out all the stops around here. You
this
know,
is incredible.
Georgia State is the megatop phoenix for.
So I'm curious about.
For Verizon Communications.
I have to ask. I'll probably get smacked
sure.
for asking, but
no.
I have to ask. What this policy is about not announcing that somebody's coming to the station?
I didn't know what policy
blows
was.
Me away.
I didn't know what policy was. There isn't a policy. I didn't know that. I'm new in
policy
PR
about
too.
Not announcing.
Because I've never heard
Jim
anybody
called,
announce.
Can you announce like you know say like Marty's coming down? We're going to be down
that's
a little bit.
About to end.
And she said, no,
I did it.
Oh, that's fine.
As
we
soon
can,
as I went
I'll
on.
I'll go into this.
Okay.
Can you?
Yeah.
Upstairs to church under the Milky Way.
Okay. Yeah, because this is only drummer, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's very
well, we can talk about
Patti Smith.
And also it's a song that she co-wrote with Delaney, who I've worked with, you know, I've written Delaney.
You guys look like the same person in these two covers.
Yeah, we are the same person.
Are you? I always suspected that.
As Patti Smith, Patti Smith got older, she metamorphosized into a younger man, which was me.
What a transition.
Yeah, and you know what happened? It became Mary Wilson Piper.
Mary Wilson Piper. Patti Wilson Piper.
Funny guys.
When was the last time that was played?
New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve?
Hey, boy. I knew how to get
there. That was obviously somebody reliving their memories on a nostalgia trip.
I don't know who that was. Do you want all the songs on the tape? Because we're about halfway through with your tape on the Atari. Want me to roll back? You want
whatever
me to roll back?
Want.
Well, it's just, you know.
Whatever you want.
It's a deal.
You've been taped about five times. Does it make you feel special?
The famous Atlanta bootlegs.
Yeah, there you go. She was.
We'll soon be releasing a two LP set.
Yeah.
Marty Wilson Piper.
With free video. Yeah.
Marty Wilson Piper, the greatest hits of songs from her. From album 88. Okay, what was
his name?
Oh, Agnes said that she went to
she was
in Chicago.
Yeah, that was such a serious storm.
It was just a storm and we couldn't get anywhere.
Nobody could get anywhere. Really affected my show badly. It was like lots and lots of people who had a prepaid ticket at $10 a go that didn't show because they couldn't get to the gig. It was like walking across the road was. You know, it was like hard to get across the road.
On the way I can't remember what snow looks like.
On the way to the airport the following day, there was like 50 cars stranded on the freeway. Just sitting
yuck.
There.
We get weather like that maybe once a year.
Yeah.
For like a couple of days.
Yeah.
But it's only half an inch of snow. You know, it freezes down here and people.
A half an inch of snow will shut down the city, where up there it takes about 8 feet.
I'm hoping I'll be able to get into the show tonight. I'm underage. So
am I.
Underage?
Half the jocks are underage.
You have to be 21.
Old love to kill, but not for voting. Why would I want
to do that? Okay, we got about 30 seconds.
You guys are,
ask Kevin. He's the man to see about getting into the show underage.
Yeah, whatever you want.
Yeah, we're underage, both of us. I'm underage.
If you're old enough
I'm 19.
If you're old enough to interview me, you're old enough to see my
Here we go.
You're old enough to, yeah.
It's a common thing I do.
But you have to drink lots of beer tonight.
Yeah. I don't drink anyway. You ready?
Say when.
When?
So anyways,
Hi, I'm Lisa on Album 88 Live with Marty Wilson Piper of the Church and more recently himself. We heard Patti Smith.
Live with myself?
We heard Patti Smith from 1975 in her album Horses, an influence.
Oh yeah,
okay.
Definitely.
Tell us about her.
Well,
yourself,
when that album came out, it was a very important day because it was like a jewel in the mud of a lot of 70s music. Mm-hmm. Fantastic words, great singing, an original sound. Tom Verlaine playing guitar on that track.
Also your new drummer?
Yeah, J.D. Doughty.
The Church?
Yeah, the drummer in Patti Smith Group is... for those of you who know, Patti Smith has just only made one album in the last 10 years, which came out a couple of years ago. J.D. Doughty is her drummer. Richard, our drummer, is taking a year holiday. Mm-hmm. And J.D. Doughty is our new drummer. He's going to be playing with us for the rest of 1990.
And I take it you're excited about it?
Yeah, well, I met him in New York a couple of weeks ago, and we did a rehearsal. And it's funny because we didn't audition drummers for it. We just said, now, who do we want? And we thought, J.D. Doughty from the Patti Smith Group, he's probably available because Patti Smith isn't touring, and and he's a guy who we really like because of the band he's been in, and we love his style. So we just called him up and asked him, and he said yes. So
wonderful.
Great. It's great getting a new... I mean, Richard's been in the band for 10 years, and we managed to replace him without having an audition, which is really something.
Let's talk about other influences now. Who do you listen to? Who do you like?
Well, you know, there's a lot of... I don't know if these kind of things get to America. I suppose they do, but there's a lot of new things coming out of Manchester and England at the moment. And, well, just out of England in general, there's a new band called Ride, mm-hmm. who's on the Creation label, I think. They've got a great new 12-inch EP out. And The House of Love, of course, mm-hmm. they made a good new album.
Yeah.
And there's the Stone Roses hype.
We like the Stone Roses,
yeah,
here.
Which we don't know whether we believe or not. We'll see in a year's time. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, there's The Wedding Present and the Inspiral Carpets, and there's another great band from Manchester called The Charlatans. Mm-hmm. They have a track called Indian Rote on Dead Good Records. I should be a DJ, because I know my stuff.
Yeah, there you go. Your solo record's a lot more acoustic than the Church stuff.
Mm.
Is there a reason for that?
Yeah, money.
Okay. Anything else? You like acoustic stuff?
Well,
you play 12
I do.
String,
no, I do noticed. Like. I really do like acoustic stuff a lot. But mm-hmm. the thing about it is that when the Church makes a record, it gets, you know, they send you to Los Angeles for 3 months and
yeah.
put you in a warehouse and say do whatever you want. You know,
mm-hmm.
when I make a record, I have to go down to a set. I do have my own 16-track studio, but it's in a cellar and I can't really use drums in there, and it's mm-hmm. damp on the walls. You know, and it's a lot more difficult for me to sort of set up a band and record a band.
And you like 12 string?
Yeah.
I've noticed.
Yeah, I play a lot of acoustic 12 string. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Not so much electric 12 string at this particular time, because about 2 years ago I had all my guitars stolen from my management office in New York City.
I know.
And one of the guitars that I had stolen was my very beautiful old Rickenbacker at 12 string from 1965. Sounds like Spinal Tap, and maybe that's true, but the fact is it was a beautiful guitar. And ever since I had that guitar stolen, I've sort of lost the plot with 12 string a bit. I
mm-hmm.
I just can't really find one to replace it. So electrically, I'm sort of playing a lot more 6 string,
mm-hmm.
but acoustically, I still play, and I probably play more 12 string. Like when I do my shows, I play only 12 string.
Okay,
guitar.
So you're going to be playing 12 string tonight?
Yeah.
Okay.
Unless I break a string. The point.
Yeah.
Point.
Okay. Performing for all of us. And right now I'm going to play something off of your first one, In Reflections.
Yeah, Reflections.
How come they don't touch the ground? What's it about?
I recorded this album years ago. I haven't got a single idea what it's about.
Okay. How come they don't touch the ground? From his first one, it's Marty Wilson Piper here, live with us in the studios on Album 88. We're going to do something live.
Yeah.
We've got to cross that off. Okay, now we're going to do this. You want to do any more influence stuff? Or is that good enough for you?
Sure.
Okay. Anything you really want to play?
There's things that people in Atlanta need to
Isn't
know about.
Isn't this wonderful? Hey, seriously, we want to introduce some people here to good music. Yeah. I mean, we're tired of the local
It has
scene.
Been 2 months since Patti yeah. Smith had been played, so it was high time.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Well, look, just let me have a quick look. Just hold that for me. Oh, you can. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, you actually can't put it down, but what you can do is put
That's
it on
right.
a chair.
Okay. I understand,
that
believe
that
me.
Lead that sticks out there, you can't put it on there.
Okay.
Oops, excuse me.
What's our status?
Our status? Oh, no.
I can do it late. I mean,
yeah, can you do it late? Would you mind?
That's cool. I'm ready to go. Whenever you folks are.
This is wonderful.
Whenever you find fresh folks, you're ready. I'm ready.
Got any Bebop Deluxe?
We used to.
Got any Cockney Rebel? Cockney Rebel, you heard of Cockney
Rebel? Yeah, in the middle of that, I was wrong.
Bebop Deluxe.
Okay, this next one.
He's gonna play live.
Okay, this next one.
He's gonna play live. I want to be able to like make sure I don't lose around the show.
That's fine. I'll just move.
Just make sure.
Oh, no problem. No problem. I'll just like. Is it a good thing?
Made in Heaven by Bebop Deluxe.
Okay.
This was last played.
She's a
maid. August.
Still, that's pretty good. For this set, by Sade.
Where did you live? Sade, where did you live?
Sonia's on the phone.
Sonia. Do you remember Sonia? She wants to know if you need
anything. On DMG Aerostar.
What do you want? Yes, Maid in Heaven?
Yes,
okay. What song is Maid in Heaven?
The promotion of
the event.
She wants to
know
Aerostar.
Yeah, yeah, no, I remember, yeah, I remember.
And she's on the flyer. Well, yeah, well, cross. I just want to make sure it doesn't move.
Stone Roses, any Stone Roses, the singles and.
Yeah,
this is when you get the part of the car or something.
Oh, yeah, did they? Yeah, because I've got the album, but I've got the European version.
You want me to hold it?
So, I know my music, I tell you.
Okay.
Spend all my money on it. But yeah, you know, and Peter Murphy.
He's struck up. I mean, if you haven't
Yeah. Well, let's talk about this after I've done this. Right. House of Love.
Yeah.
It was scratched on the log.
Yeah, because I was going to give one here.
Oh, you've got it.
Yeah. Okay, you want to play live after this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we can talk about Bebop Deluxe a bit if you want.
Okay. Oops.
This is great. I mean, I could tell you, if I could go around the country playing my favorite records and doing live things myself, then I would be really into that. Because
this is a lot of fun for us. It's something you know, different.
Yeah,
we
because
love it.
I mean, I've got 4,000 albums, you know.
Are you a record collector?
Yeah,
I was going to ask you about it, but I didn't know if you were or not.
I'm a huge record collector. I really know about records and, you know, right from like 62 onwards, I just know a lot about records and music.
Yeah. I'm impressed. I'm very impressed.
I mean, I even know about what record just came out, you know, so I do really keep up on it.
I'm impressed.
I have to have a copy of this.
This?
Yeah, this is a reflection.
Yeah, right.
I have to have a copy of this. You know what? How can I get one of those 300 that are going to be pressed? How can you get one?
I don't know.
God
no
damn
idea.
It. How are we going to get one of these?
This guy that helped me with information for this, this guy needs this record. You
Does
don't
he?
Understand. He's like, you've
you
got to find
you
a way
can't
to
get it. There's no way to get it.
You see, there's a list of people 1,000 strong that want this album. There's only 300 coming out. I mean, I know 1,000 people personally who want this album. Maybe I should...
Oh, you didn't.
Yeah.
Dude, good job.
Do you want to play any rockin' stuff?
It's Lucas guitar.
Sister Siegel.
Your stuff?
Of my stuff?
Yeah. You want anything upbeat? Really upbeat?
This is like one of the greatest guitar players to ever live.
Who is it?
Bill Nelson.
Bill Nelson.
This is before my time.
She's a maid in heaven.
Marty did.
Oh my God.
Good job, huh?
Oh gosh, I hope Jim doesn't get offended.
Jim?
Jim, I'm gonna ask why Ryko.
Why Ryko? Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because we love Jim Neal. That's why Ryko.
I am Ryko this.
You wanna have a seat?
President of the morning.
You need more coffee?
No, I'm okay.
English rock. C label for correct cuts.
So I forgot the classic as well.
Sounds good. It's the first time I've ever heard anything by this band.
Yeah.
You guys went 3 years without playing this song at all.
Really?
3 years. 7/11/86 to 8/6/89.
Wow.
3 years.
3 years without
playing. And then they played the same cut. Played the same cut in that 3 year period. Played the same exact cut.
This is also my first interview.
Is it?
Oh, cool.
This is really
going to be a
lot. Okay, we're almost off.
Love with the
Madman. I'm just going to introduce it and say 1975 Bebop Deluxe from Futurama. Album 88 playing Bebop Deluxe from 1975 off of Futurama with Maid in Heaven and Marty Wilson Piper. Hi.
Hi. I don't know what it is with 1975, but that was a pure coincidence that it was the same year as Horses. It really was.
You like Bebop Deluxe?
Yeah, oh yeah. God, Bill Nelson was a huge influence of mine. I never could really play guitar like that, but I was never the sort of kind of guitarist who really wanted to sort of try and imitate people who I liked. I wasn't ever that kind of a guitarist. I always really wanted to have my own style of playing. So, but as far as enjoyment, I loved this guy's playing. I thought he was a fantastic guitarist. He wrote amazing words. He had a really cool voice. And I still buy all the records that he makes now, and I've got every record he's ever done. Now he's become, of course, he has a lot of very instrumental records, and he plays with David Sylvian and people like that.
Uh-huh.
And he actually, in about 1978 or 79, he kind of stopped playing guitar and started concentrating on making a more kind of, being one of the innovators of ambient music. He's a fantastic, creative man, and I love everything he does.
Well, how about your writing? On your liner notes, you often say that you write in certain places.
Yeah.
In all the songs.
Yeah.
Is that very important to you?
Well, you know, it's this thing about a stranger in town notices the details that the people who live there don't, and I'm sure that helps me. I think I'm quite an observant, observant person. Mm-hmm. You know, so I.
Do you have any place where you write best?
In front of fires.
Really?
Because all the lyrics are burning in the embers. I don't know, you know. When it's raining.
We're not ready to move on yet.
Yeah.
You're touring without Andy.
Yeah.
Beloved friend.
Yeah, my beloved Andy. He, this month, he's actually engineering the new Blow Monkeys album.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so
okay.
He couldn't. My tour and his schedule for that project was the same 3 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And he, of course, that's a big break for him.
Yeah.
And he, of course, couldn't cancel, and I couldn't change my tour because the new Church record is about to come out in the middle of March. So I miss touring with him because he's my best mate and we have a good laugh, you know, and all that. But but it has actually been going well with me doing it by myself. It's a different show by myself.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't have the harmonies, which Andy always used to be a big contribution of him, but I, you know, it's something else. So, I mean, it works on its own level, you know. Mm-hmm.
Why Ryko? You're on Ryko now.
Well, I got signed to Ryko. I mean, I don't know why I got signed. I suppose they heard the music and liked it, you know.
It's not something that you picked out?
No, it's not something I picked out particularly. Okay. It's something my manager might have picked out.
Okay.
But the thing about Ryko is that they are, it's like the quality is their middle name. You know, they whenever I want to release anything with a glossy cover or five colors on the album cover or, you know, gatefold or whatever it is, you know, they just say, sure, of course. They're very into their things being of a high quality. And I mean, there's nothing worse than getting hold of a record, which is, I mean, this, of course, this doesn't apply so much now because we've moved from vinyl, mm-hmm. much to my dismay.
Yeah. New One isn't out on vinyl.
No, it's not. Not in America. It is in Europe out on vinyl.
Okay.
Much to my dismay, we've moved from vinyl to CD. Mm-hmm. But in the early 80s, sometimes you'd pick up an album which might have been released in its original country in a thick cardboard gatefold with a lyric sheet and photographs and, you know, free postcards of, mm-hmm. you know, Phil Oakey from the Human League in the bath or whatever it was.
Uh-huh.
And then it would come out in America and it would be in flimsy soft cardboard, no gatefold, no inner sleeve, you know. Mm-hmm. And I always used to hate that when you get a record, because I am a record collector, you know, so I kind of used to get into, you know, getting the original cover and all the words and stuff, and used to think, oh God, cheapo, you know, they released it how it wasn't meant to be, and I always thought the artist must have been so angry about that, you know, and the church hasn't really had to put up with that. Oh, actually we have, the Blurred Crusade, the second church album, was released in some territories as a gatefold and other places as a single cover, so we have had to put up with that too. It's kind of annoying.
Want to play something live for us?
Yeah, why not? Oh, look, there's a guitar in my hands. I might as well.
You're going to play Melody of the Rain?
Yeah, I thought it was appropriate for this inspiring Atlanta day.
Yeah, this rainy Thursday. You're also going to be playing tonight.
Yeah, am I? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Where are you playing?
The Point.
With all of us there, we'll all be there.
So this is a song which actually I wrote in a hotel in Springfield, Massachusetts. This is another song I wrote in America. I think I write a lot of these songs in America because I sort of tend to be here a lot with the church, and I tour around, and you know, like 2 or 3 hours before you have to do a sound check or something, I, you know, get the guitar out and write some tunes, because there isn't much other time to write. When you get home, you know, it's like you want to. Last thing you want to do is look at a guitar, you know.
Mm-hmm. Well, let me do a plug here. Okay. Album 88 and Marty Wilson Piper with Melody of the Rain.
And my voice may crack halfway through this, but I can blame the rain for that.
That's
too,
okay, so. We don't mind.
Here we go. Glad the bathtub's paid, fluffed and clean.
to know, but if I try to touch them, I can't reach that high. Still, it seems so. I run and spin and I turn and turn and dance. What have I done to earn this day? So simple and peculiar to enjoy. Simple melody that hopefully won't ever go. Sit me down right by the fire to read a book and be inspired. My favorite room. Mozart climbs into my head. I fell asleep, should go to bed. Music woke me from the dead. I hear you home. Come on, you enjoy my open heart. Cheat.
On album 88, live in the studios with us.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about the church a little bit.
The church.
What you doing with them right now? What are they doing? You got a new album coming out in March?
It's called Gold Afternoon Fix.
Uh-huh.
It's coming March the 14th, I think it is, all around there somewhere.
Okay.
It's got a new single out called Metropolis, which is, I think, just about arriving everywhere now.
Mm-hmm. You gonna tour?
Yeah, we're gonna do it. We start. Go to Australia. JD and I go to Australia in.
You go to.
Pardon?
The home.
That place. To rehearse before we start a tour there.
Mm-hmm.
And like Steve's in Los Angeles at the moment, working on another Hex record.
Okay.
And
Peter's. He's got his own stuff out right now too.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm. And Peter's in somewhere in Australia. I don't know what he's doing. And we're going to meet, rehearse. Do 3 or 4 gigs in Australia, then we go to England and we do a British tour and a European tour. Then I think we're going to be in America in like late spring, early summer.
Wonderful.
But we're intending on doing a sort of summer-ish tour of the USA.
Good.
Yeah.
Have you been playing big clubs by yourself, or have you been?
I've been. Yeah, it's been like the small clubs. I've been doing 2 shows at.
Uh-huh.
And the big clubs, 1. You know.
You've been now, in New York and Chicago. Lately?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like New York, I did 2 shows because it was only a small capacity. In LA, I did 2 shows because it was only a small capacity. But I've actually been pulling some quite nice crowds, you know, 300 people plus, which I think is pretty good for a guy with an acoustic guitar, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty happy about that. And people seem to like it.
Yeah, and we've got a lot of acoustic music in Atlanta, so we're looking forward to the show. Yeah,
yeah.
Lots.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I do.
Well, we want everyone to come out too.
Yeah.
Where are we going to play
point,
tonight?
Right.
We're at the point tonight.
Do you keep asking me that because you keep forgetting or because...
No, we like the music.
They need to know where it is.
The point. I'm going to play She's King.
Okay.
Unless you want to play something else live.
Nah, play it. I mean, see you tonight. I mean, I've got a bit of a voice problem here at the moment. My voice is running out, so maybe it is better that we just do that one and play some tracks, and I'll do it all tonight and try and keep in tune and not break halfway through.
Okay, She's King off of Art Attack, and Marty Wilson Piper live from Album 88 Studios, and coming to you tonight at the point. Thanks for stopping by, we really appreciate
it. It's been a lot of fun.
See you later.
Yeah, I was good, just one.
Yeah.
Your voice is too raspy. I was going to say something earlier about having to ask you for another one.
Okay.
I didn't think about it.
Fine.
I got sidetracked.
Yeah, I should sort of watch it, you know? Because as soon as
I get on, you stay one more song.
Sure. But let's play. Can I play another track?
Sure. Whatever you want. 88.
You have any
sure. Hold on. Wait a minute. You want to answer a question for a fan?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Just a second. I'm going to put you on the speakerphone. Okay. Okay. You're on speakerphone. Can you hold on for a minute?
Yeah.
Okay. Marty Wilson Piper on the air with you and Album 88 off of John Cale's 1974 album. Fair. Fear is a man's best friend.
Yeah.
You want to talk about it? You like it?
Yeah, well, you know, the thing is, I mean, I've just been sticking around this 75, 74 era. I think that there's a lot of folks out there today who would really, really like a lot of the stuff that wasn't really successful around that period,
yeah.
And they don't know about it. You know, people talk about the 70s and they go, oh, the Eagles, oh God, Led Zeppelin, oh my God, Leonard Skinner, you know? And like it's, there's all this stuff that didn't have an effect on the populace, but it had an effect on people like me, you know,
mm-hmm.
who was looking for interesting music, and I think that the same 19-year-old person today would probably be as excited about Fear is a Man's Best Friend by John Cale as they would probably by, you know, Mary My Hope, who are playing tonight, you know. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with Mary My Hope, but there's old great things that people don't know about that they should be educated about, as well as the new things which are still around touring and playing. So that's one of them.
Well, thanks.
And Bebop Deluxe is another. And
Patti Smith.
And I could go on and on.
We've got you tonight at the Point, and we've got a pair of passes for, let's say, the Ninth Color. Yeah?
The Ninth Color.
Let's make it 8 for Album 88. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, yeah.
Marty Wilson Piper at the Point
sure.
tonight, live in the studios. You wanna do a little thing for this?
What do I want to say?
Be the Eighth Caller.
Be the
and win a pair of passes.
Okay. Be the Eighth Caller.
A 21 to go. I'm sorry, guys. It's a 21 and over show. While you're listening to that, to this, what are we gonna play here?
Storm the Door. Ignore the Rules.
Right, exactly. To Where I Am Now.
Sorry.
You want to talk about it before we play it?
Oh yeah, To Where I Am Now. That's a song.
Yeah. Off of your newest one called Rhyme.
Yeah. What can I tell you about that?
If you want to say anything.
That's a song. Actually, that song I wrote. When did I write
his favorite song? It's
Kevin, my tour manager's favorite song. It's actually my manager's favorite song as well, so everybody's favorite song. And it was written in, I don't know what to tell you about it until I see where it's written. it's written in Sydney, Australia. Oh,
on a beach someplace, yeah.
Yeah, now that was written in Des Moines, in a little suburb I lived for about 6 months when my girlfriend first came to Australia.
Uh-huh.
And that song, I actually recorded it once before on I did this show, I don't know if any of you knows what KCRW is, which is a really great LA show with a girl called Deirdre O'Donoghue, who runs this fantastic radio show. She plays the greatest music. And I went on there and played live acoustic on her show a couple of years ago and played that song. So there's actually and she released it on a tape from that radio station. So this is actually the second released recorded version, but it's a bit different.
Okay.
It's a song that, you know, as I say, a couple of people really think this is the best song I ever wrote, so judge for yourself.
Off of his latest one called Rhyme, Marty Wilson Piper live in the studios on Album 88, To Where I Am Now. Goodbye, Atlanta.
So you want to do that?
Sorry, didn't win.
We're like very vicious around here. I'll be like,
yeah,
go ahead.
No.
Album 88, Color 2, try again.
What am I watching on? GS
Moving Ground, GS TV.
Alright, go ahead. Hello, my name's Marty Wilson Piper, and you're watching Proving Ground on GST TV.
Thank you.